Good morning, friends. I am Rajan Prasad, and at present you are viewing my channel Raj Photo Tech. In this episode, we will learn how to remove acne, blemishes and wrinkles in Lightroom. A common question I get from my students is how to fix acne and blemishes without taking the help of Photoshop. Many of you will be pleasantly surprised to find out that you can do basic photo touch-ups directly in Lightroom. In fact, often we can complete all our touch-ups in Lightroom without having to take our images into Photoshop at all. If you have not subscribed my channel, then please subscribe it and press the bell icon to get notification about our new tutorials. Lightroom Spot Removal tool was first added in Lightroom for removing the spots due to dirty sensor. Many Lightroom users do not realize how useful the spot removal tool can be for fixing acne, blemishes and scratches etc. The spot removal tool continues to be improved with each Lightroom release and now can really handle most of your healing and cloning needs. The second tool from the toolbox is a spot removing tool. Click to select it, or for even quicker results, you can activate it by simply placing the letter Q, which is its shortcut. The spot removal tool is used to remove unwanted objects or blemishes via one or two modes, clone mode or heal mode. The clone mode is best for hiding unwanted objects by covering them with a copy of another area in the image, but it does not blend the healed areas with the pixels around it. The heal mode is best for fixing blemishes, scratches, etc. because it blends the healed area with the pixels around it. First, zoom the portion of the image you would like to retouch. In the top right hand corner in the navigator panel, you have a few view options available for zooming. Those are fit, fill, 1:1, and at the right there are additional zoom. As you are seeing here, you can use any of them as needed. Once you are zoomed in, you can use the navigator box to see the different areas of the image, as I am showing you here. Or just press the space bar. You can see that the cursor has changed in the hand tool, and now you can drag your image with this to reposition. When done, leave the space bar. As I am showing you. Before you start retouching, adjust the brush size, feather and opacity. For the brush size, use the smallest size possible, just enough to cover the area you are trying to retouch. For changing the size of the brush, use this slider or use the left and right bracket to do it quickly. As I am showing you here. Press the left bracket to reduce the size of the brush and press the right bracket to increase the size. The feather feature softens edges of the brush, since a hard edge can be more noticeable in some instances. So use a soft brush for better result. This slider will help you to control the feathering amount. You can adjust the opacity of the brush with this slider when you don't want to cover up a spot completely. Now for removing acne and blemishes, select the heal mode. Heal mode works by automatically resampling nearby best guess pixels that will perfectly blend in with the area you are retouching. Now select an area to retouch. In this case, I am going to remove this acne to show you. To do this, place the cursor over the area and click once. And as you can see, the blemish is now removed. Sometimes you may need to make the slight adjustment to the original coverage area, the area being sampled, or brush size. To change the coverage area, place the cursor over the original area And when the cursor turns into hand tool, you can then move the location. When the computer-based guess at sampling similar pixels was in fact not a great guess, you can move the sample area by placing the cursor over the second circle that has an arrow attached to it and move it to a better location, as I am doing here. If you have used the spot healing brush in Photoshop, then you will realize that this facility to modify the sampling area is not present there. So this tool is better than that. If you need to change the size of the brush to have a larger or a smaller coverage area, you simply put the cursor near the edge of the original circle. Your cursor will change in double arrow and now drag until you see the appropriate size. I am now removing all the blemishes and you can see how quickly and easily it can be done. Now see the before and after images to compare. Now let us see how to remove or reduce the appearance of wrinkles. Removing wrinkles can be a little challenging compared to removing a blemish. This is because the coverage is often larger and continuous. For this, I am taking another image. To remove or reduce wrinkles, repeat the same steps as above. But this time, drag the circle along the length of the wrinkle. If you want to completely remove the wrinkle, set the brush opacity to 100. See, I am removing these wrinkles. Now see the before and after to compare. But removing all wrinkles can give a fake or unnatural look. For the wrinkles, it is better not to remove it completely, just lessen their appearance by sliding the opacity to 60. This gives the portrait a more natural and realistic look. Now I have moved the opacity slider to 60 and again removing the wrinkles. See before and after and you will feel it looks more natural. Photoshop has a tool known as Content Aware Fill that analyzes the area around a selection to figure out what pixels to generate to fill the selection and remove an unwanted object. This tool is not provided in Lightroom, but you can do the same thing with a spot healing brush in Lightroom. For demonstration, I am taking this picture and I will try to remove this girl from the image. This is not an easy task, but see how easily you can do it with a spot removal tool. So now you must have convinced that this tool is more powerful than you think. Now use its full potential. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Meet you again in next tutorial. Bye for now. Have a nice day. I hope you enjoyed our tutorial. Kindly subscribe and like our video channel for more interesting video tutorials. If you want to get notification about our upcoming tutorials, kindly press the bell icon. See you again in the next tutorial. Goodbye and have a nice day.